Hi friends, welcome back to Hobby Plus. Today I am discuss about relaxation oscillator. That is a relaxation oscillator circuit. Here is a SCR and here is a UJT. UJT means unijunction transistor. Here is a motor which is the load of the circuit. Here is a potentiometer, here is a capacitor. The capacitor value is 10 to 100 microfarad and the potentiometer value is 10k. You can do this circuit with your op amp. That you can also do by op amp, but I use here UJT. I can tell you something about this SCR. SCR is nothing. SCR is a simple rectifier. It gives you more power. But in the third pin, I mean here it is number 2, the number 2 pin is have a gate and you can control the voltage through this circuit. If you control this circuit, if you control this gate voltage, then you can control the output power of the SCR. A little and simple theory of the SCR. It is also used for commercial and domestic purpose both. But the relaxation oscillator can control this voltage. Now I can tell you how it works. Look at this. That is your capacitor charging curve. If you put here a high value resistance, that means your capacitor charging time goes to high. So when it is completely charged, when this capacitor is going to complete charge, then the emitter through V1, the charge going to discharge. Then in that time you can get a voltage. So that means your SCR gate can get voltage from the discharging time. So that is your discharging time, then you get this voltage, maximum peak to minimum peak. Look at this, and that is the maximum voltage to minimum voltage. That means that is the point which is cannot give you any voltage, so you cannot get any power from the output of the SCR. But if you use the circuit in different way, that means I want to mean get if you put your gate into V2 of the UJT, that means that is your output curve. So you get more power, that means on time is high and off time is low. It is absolutely depend on the circuit where I use this circuit. That means if you want to drive your motor for little time and maximum time goes to be off, that means you have to use this curve, means V1 is the suitable for your circuit. If you want more power and more maximum time motor should be on and little time you stop your motor, you want to stop your motor, then you use the V2 part. V2 junction you can control and V1 junction, both are controlled in the same time. Look at this. So you can design the circuit according to this curve. If you change the potentiometer value, then you can change the on time and off time. That means you can control your motor through this potentiometer. And I hope you understand everything. But you never forget that here is the two different resistance. One is here, another is here, both value are same. So it is easy to make. You can make it, test it. After that you tell me it is working or not. Have you any problem? Then you tell me in my comment box. Have you any suggestion? Then you also tell me that. Thank you. Thank you for watching.